Hello and welcome back to the second module of this e-learning course on digital skills in the classroom. And in this module, we're going to be looking at a very, very important skill. We're going to be looking at how to improve your search technique, something which I believe is done badly by teachers, professionals, and of course, young people across the whole of Europe. So, improving your search. The neuroscientist Susan Greenfield once said, "In a world so rich in information and answers, the most important skill for the learner is the ability to frame the right question." And she couldn't have been more right. Any search engine relies on the types of input that you put into it in the first place. Let's illustrate this by looking at this little video. Interesting, isn't it? What a great example of the fact that if you don't know what you're looking for, if you don't ask the right questions, then it's almost impossible to find actually what you're looking for at the end. For example, if I'd asked you to look out for the griller, you'd have spotted it straight away. But by distracting you, asking you to count how many times people pass the white balls, it was almost impossible to find the answer to the question that you were looking for. The white balls, if you like, are good symbolism to all of the other stuff that's out there on the internet. Let's go back now and have a little think about how we can get young people searching for things more effectively. One way to do it, and a good lesson, is to actually get them developing search terms on pieces of paper first. By removing the technology, what you're trying to do is you're trying to get them to think about the keywords, the key search terms. Then, when they've developed the key search terms, you introduce the technology on a mobile phone, a tablet, or a laptop, and they see which one of them within the class has managed to get the best results. Of course, there's lots of other things that have happened as well. It's important to remember that Google has really evolved since it was first founded in 1998. Try Googling Google in 1998 and see what happens. So, let me give you some helpful tips about how you might use Google more effectively. First of all, remember that you can use the tabs across the top of the page. This allows you to switch between web, video images, news, etc., etc., etc. Think about trying to use important words only. So instead of "where can I find a Chinese restaurant that delivers," how about you just search for Google for Chinese restaurants nearby? Remember, Google is location aware. Or pizza places near me. Keep it as simple as possible. You can search for multiple words at once as well. For example, all you need to do is to put in the best way to prepare for job interviews or how to prepare for job interviews. So what you're doing there is you're asking it to look for one thing or the other. Chocolate or white chocolate. Gradually add search terms to try and build up a better picture. Very similar to the paper exercise that I explained earlier. Job interviews. Preparing for job interviews, how to prepare for job interviews, and you'll notice the search results change each time. Try to use words that websites will use. So rather than "I have a flat tire," how about "repair a flat tire?" Or rather than "my head hurts," how about "headache relief?" Don't worry too much about spelling. Google has actually got a built-in spell checker, which is really, really good, perhaps better than some of the ones that you find on most modern word processors. Use descriptive words as much as possible, or think about different ways to ask the same question if you're not happy with the results. Google itself has got a really good resource on how to use the search engine. Here's the URL here. It's a little bit complicated, but of course, if you just Google how to search on Google, you'll get the results straight away. Google's also got an advanced search function, which I suggest that you have a look at. We're going to have a look at this advanced function in a bit more detail in the next video. Until then, don't forget there's lots of online support from all of the other people that are taking part in this e-learning course on developing digital skills in your classroom. I'll see you in the next video, which is about advanced Google search.